Bonjour à tous.
Or bonjour tout le monde. Good morning or good day everyone. Today let us see 16th exercise in page number 46. So please refer page number 46 of your book PDF. So what they have done there is they have given an example, and same like the example they want you to solve the remaining five. So let me explain the example first and then let us move on to the remaining five exercises. So this is the question. Who telephone avotrami? You call your friend. So you have to change it in two ways. One is, did you call your friend? So for that it is esker. You have to put esker and you have to put an question mark at the last. Then next one is, who telephone should be changed to, it inversion should happen. Inversion means if you write the verb, if you have to bring the verb in the front and who should be next. So in order to make it, you have to put an hyphen here. This is called inversion. So you are just writing it vice versa. Okay, inversed, you are just writing it in inversed form. So for that you are bringing the verb in front. Okay, you are bringing the verb in front and then subject here. Okay, here hyphen telephone hyphen vu avotru ami. Got it? Then let me move on to the first one. A tu fini tontra vai. So for this you have to write esker. Did you finish your work? Esker should be written and you have to put a question mark. And second one, inversion. For inversion, you should bring the verb in front and insert an hyphen and then you bring the subject and at last question mark. Finitu tondravai. Then, el sortle shiyan. Esker el sortle shiyan. So for this, Esker L. So E is a vowel here. So you are putting QU apostrophe. Okay. And then El Sortla Shia means she took, she takes the, Shia means dog. She takes the Shia out. Did she take the, dog out. Okay, sortel, you have to vice versa, you have to inverse it. Okay, then so in order to inverse it, you have to bring the verb here and the subject here and hyphen here and you have to put a question mark. Then Lily has a passport. Lily has a passport. So you have to write esker. Eska Lily Asam passport means, is Lily having her passport? Like that. And you are writing a question mark here. Then, since A is present in the sentence, so you cannot, while inversing, you cannot write like this. A hyphen L, because A is a vowel, E is also a vowel. Okay. So, in order to avoid clashing of two vowels in between, you have to put a T and you have to bridge both. So that is what is written here. So A is a vowel, E is a vowel. So if both the vowels are next, you have to put insert a T in between. So that's what even I have done. I have written the name of the person and comma A tells on passport, because Lily is the name of a girl, feminine, so L. So that's what I have taken, L conjugation here. Got it? Okay, now let me move on to the next one. El parle. El parle en classe. Okay, so Esca el parle en classe. Did she speak in the class? Did she speak in the class? Okay, so E is a vowel, so you put QU apostrophe. Okay, then parle tel en classe. So while inversing it, it will become like this. Parle
hyphen l. So here is a vowel, here is a vowel, so there should not be a clash between these. Okay, so it should not end up like this. Here is a vowel and here is also again starting with a vowel. So in order to avoid that, again you are inserting a t here. Got it? Then the next one is verifiez-vous l'horaire du bus l'aéroport. So as usual, you have to put est-ce. You verify the arrival of arrival time in the airport, like that they are asking. So you have put est-ce here, and then verifiez-vous, so you are just inversing it. So verifier, verb should come here, and hyphen, and then vous. Okay, subject. So in order to inverse it, in hyphen is very important, and question mark at the last. So that's all. With this, we are finishing off this exercise, and then let me move on to the next one, page number 46, 17th exercise. Translate to English. Okay, mama, je ne veux pas d'idli. Mama, mama means mummy. I don't want any idli. I don't want any idli. Duri, next one is duri means je ne assez. Duri means some rice. Duri means some rice. Je ne assez means I have enough of it. Then, je veux prendre du riz. I want to take some rice. I want to take some rice. Then, next one is, nous ne voulons pas de chapati. We do not want any chapati. We do not want any chapati. Then, elle ne veut pas boire de café noir. She does not want to drink black coffee. Okay, café noir means black coffee. Got it, everybody? Okay, so it is just translation of what, I mean, the sentence is given. The sentence is given. You are just translating translating to English and writing. That's it. Very, very easy exercise. So, hope it is clear. Today, we saw interrogative sentences. Out of that, first type is introducing esque. Second type is inversion. So, introducing esque is as usual. Esque you have to write, and if it is starting with vowel like this, you have to put QU apostrophe. And then for inversion, you have to just inverse and write. Verb should come front, and next you should write the subject, and you have to put an hyphen in between. And then here there should not be a clash between two vowels. In order to avoid that, you are introducing a T here. Okay. Merci. Merci beaucoup. Bonjour, ne.